Welcome back to Proactive London, where I'm joined in person by Tom Bailey, who's the head of ETF research at HANetf. Tom, it's great to see you. How are things?
Great, thank you.
A very warm welcome to you today. And it's a very big day for HANetf because you've launched a brand new fund. Perhaps you can introduce it for us.
Great, yeah, sure. So the ETF is called the Future of Defence, UCITS ETF, and its ticker is NATO. And today, 4th of July, we listed it on the London Stock Exchange and also Xetra in Frankfurt. It's also going to be listed in Borsa Italiana in the coming weeks. So the idea behind the ETF, to kind of just simply state it, is to kind of capture the growth of defence, both in terms of industrial, kind of traditional defence companies, but also crucially the cybersecurity aspect of defence today. So with cyber playing an increasingly important role in national security.
All right then. So it's a NATO-focused defence tracking fund that people can buy into. Why now, do you think, Tom?
Well, I think if you look at the kind of geopolitical situation, the way it's developed in the last couple of years, we're in a very different world than we were in, say, 5 years ago. We kind of started to see this kind of breakdown of what you could call the post-Cold War order in terms of, say, the end of communism in Eastern Europe and then the kind of coming together of Europe. When you start seeing the increased tensions between US and China in the South China Sea, particularly, overstates of Taiwan, and then you see the trade war under the Trump administration, which is very much geopolitically, as much as it was about, say, domestic issues, it's also driven by this kind of geopolitical tensions caused by the rise of China and the US as a global dominant power. But we see beyond this as well, obviously, the invasion of Ukraine last year by Russia is obviously another kind of one of these big flashpoints. So if you look around the world today, we think we're in a more perilous geopolitical world than we were several years ago. Whether it is, as I mentioned, the South China Sea, whether it is Russia's invasion and ongoing war in Ukraine, and also what that means for the other countries in Central and Eastern Europe, and then also around the world globally, you can see that in the Sahel of Africa, it's still very unstable. So last year was the largest ever spending on military defence ever in the world, on the latest figures. This was also the case for Central and Western Europe. They spent more last year than they had on military than they had since the end of the Cold War. So the world's really changing in a sense. The invasion of Ukraine was a wake-up call to many of these European countries. So they're increasing their defense budgets. You can see it. So obviously the last few years, in the last 30 years, defense budgets were slashed across Europe. NATO European members were not hitting the 2% of GDP defence target for the most part. There were some notable exceptions who were. Those budgets now have to be increased and they're going to hit or exceed the 2%. So this is really the broad trend this ETF is trying to capture. But then the other aspect is, and this is why it has a ticker NATO in it, is because we wanted to provide exposure to this growing spending on defence. But we wanted to do it in a way which we were only providing exposure to what we would consider responsible geopolitical actors, i.e. only members of NATO or NATO Plus, which is a subsection of countries which haven't joined NATO formally but are classified by the US as NATO Plus. So the ETF only will include companies which are domiciled in NATO or NATO Plus countries. And really this is about ensuring that we're not providing a way to get exposure to some of the, lack of a better way of saying it, less responsible geopolitical actors on the stage.
Mm-hmm. By which you mean non-NATO countries?
Yes, not to say all non-NATO countries are, but it's a way to kind of ensure we're providing exposure to what kind of we think of NATO as a defensive alliance defending the democracies of Europe and other parts of the world.
Absolutely. And there is also an element of cybersecurity in this, isn't there? In fact, quite a big element.
Yeah, so obviously there's various different domains of warfare you can talk about, but a growing important one is cyber. You can see this. So after the first invasion of Ukraine by Russia in 2014, they launched a series of cyber attacks on the country, shutting down ATMs, shutting down energy grids, and these kind of cyber warfare. Part is you see some of the Russian military theorists talk about the idea of hybrid warfare, where it's about not just military power head on head. It's also about challenging in these other ways states that they are in hostile arrangements with. And then we've seen cyber attacks likely sponsored by Russia, China, North Korea, and Iran also globally. So no government now can ignore the importance of cyber in terms of defense. If they do engage in hostilities with other countries, they will be targeted in those ways, whether it's government organizations or even private sector, which are playing a kind of crucial role in a country's infrastructure, be it the financial system or energy, depending on their arrangements there. So what we want to do with ECF is make sure we're giving exposure to this future aspect of defense, which is growing more important. So just a small example, one of the companies in the ETF is A10 Networks, and they provide services to, say, Turk Telecom, which is the telecom company in Turkey. Obviously, Turkey being worried that were they to be in some sort of hostile situation with another country, that they will themselves be, someone would try and target their telecom infrastructure. It makes complete sense. And so you're seeing the involvement of the private sector in kind of shoring up the cybersecurity defense of key national infrastructure because of this. Mm-hmm.
What kind of investor do you think will be interested in this one, Tom?
Yeah, I mean, there's some investors who will say it's not for me. They don't want to invest in arms manufacturers because, as mentioned, it's about half cybersecurity, although those companies have to have involvement. They have contracts with countries, NATO countries. But also half is your kind of typical arms manufacturers, Thales, Leonardo, Raytheon. And there's some investors who will just say, no, it's out of my... I don't want exposure to weapons manufacturers, weapons skill people. But we don't think that's the majority view of investors. I think many investors kind of get the point that actually, you know, selling arms to countries which are defending their own borders, defending democracy, is not necessarily inherently a bad thing. But there will be those investors who will say no. They might have certain ESG requirements that will exclude them. But what we did try and do with the NATO aspect in terms of we're trying to alleviate some of those worries. But those investors won't be too keen. But we think for investors, and we did a survey for our forthcoming thematic review of wealth managers across Europe, as Italy, Germany, Switzerland, and the UK, and 80% of them roughly said that they were thinking of geopolitics more in terms of the asset allocation than they ever have been in the past. And so I think those investors who do see the world as a more perilous place and do see this kind of potential growing. Potential risk, but also and this actual buildup of military capabilities across the world, we'll see this as a potential ETF to invest in.
Thank you, Tom. So just finally, you want to remind us perhaps of where people can get access to this and the schedule when people can get it in different markets across Europe.
Sure. So as of today, 4th of July, it's listed on London Stock Exchange and also Xetra in Germany, and it should be on all major brokers. And then in mid-July, it will be listed on Borsa Italiana.
All right then. Well, we'll look for it there. Thank you very much indeed, Tom. And it was great to have you back in our proactive London studio today.
Thank you.